Guess what this episode is about? An antenna? Yeah, right. It's about a 3D printed antenna. You can set up the antenna for any frequency range between 100 MHz and 10 GHz. You may have seen my previous building instructions using copper wire or copper pipe. In addition, you can find videos about the dimensioning tool, the equivalent circuit diagram, and the tuning on this channel. Today we are realizing this antenna as a planar structure because this method has some advantages, as we will see in a minute. For the first test, I stuck aluminum foil on cardboard and then cut out the layout with scissors. It worked really well, so I thought about a sturdy 3D printing casing construction for the foil antenna. By the way, when it's coming to 3D printing, CNC manufacturing or printed circuit boards, then the sponsor of this video is a good option. Just take a look at PCBWay's websites. And there are currently awesome proposals with good discounts and special offers. I love it. I designed two parts. Between I can put my foil antenna, which I'm planning to make out of 0.1 mm copper foil. The construction also helps when cutting the foil. I tightened the screws and used some additional clamps so that the foil cannot slip while cutting. You place the foil between the parts and then simply cut off the overhanging parts using a cutter knife. We need a piece of coaxial cable, which we strip like here. The outer conductor of the coax cable will later be clamped into this small notch, and the inner conductor will be clamped here. If you want to use a thicker coaxial cable, make the notch larger accordingly. Now I need to give an important information for 3D printing. Any material near the antenna influences its properties. In this respect, 3D printing has an advantage which I didn't consider up to now. If you use a low filling grade for 3D printing, then the 3D printed structure has little influence on the electromagnetic properties of the antenna. After consulting my nephew, who has got significant experience with 3D printing, we choose the lowest possible filling level for the 3D printed parts. The outer walls of the structure are having 0.4 mm thickness. The inner filling structure comes at a ruster distance of 7 mm. It is about 0.2 to 0.3 mm thick and crossed. This corresponds to a filling level of around 8%, which I have roughly calculated here. The dielectric constant of PLA material would be 2.8 at 100% fill level. At 0% filling level, we only have air, and then the permittivity would be 1. If we assume a linear relationship between the permittivity and the degree of filling, then the following results. At 8% filling level, the permittivity is calculated from 2.8 minus 1 times 0.08 plus 1 equals 1.144. The so-called effective dielectric constant is even lower, because with a clever design, only a fraction of the space around the conductors is filled with material. In order to quantify this, you would have to compute the electric fields and to derive the effective dielectric constant from that. But I better give you a practical tip that helps you for the design of any dielectric material in that context. The electric field is concentrating in the dielectric material. You can avoid this by pockets and slits in your design. My first design worked, but not quite optimally, because I didn't fully respect that rule. That's why I simply couldn't achieve more than 15 dB of return loss. Here is the reason. I had the concentration effect mentioned, affecting the impedance matching network, causing the effective dielectric constant being not as low as desired. This reduced the electrical length and the impedance of the two-wire waveguide in my matching network. So, in the end, I couldn't reach 100% matching of the antenna for this reason. Along the loop, we can practically neglect the influence of the material. And therefore, we can assume that our 3D printed structure will hardly affect the resonant frequency of the loop. Using our Excel tool, we calculated the angle alpha of 15 degrees, and we are now putting the parts together accordingly. The curved slots allow us to change the angle alpha later in order to tune the antenna precisely. I would actually prefer to use nylon screws here, but the metal screws only have minor influence on this arrangement. And here comes the reflection measurement, which I think looks very good. I have rarely seen such a good antenna matching. The center frequency is little too high. Instead of 866 MHz, we get 917 MHz, which corresponds to about 5.8% deviation. I think I can improve my dimensioning tool with that result. I designed the antenna for free space and then tried to keep the permittivity of the material as low as possible in order to minimize the influence on the antenna's electromagnetic properties. You could also try the other way around. One could adapt the design to a specific permittivity and then we could possibly get rid of the slots. I'm definitely going to realize more ideas in this direction. Antennas are always fascinating anyway. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.